Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to today radar system class. In today class, I will explain about the butterfly effect in MDA radar. So first, I want to give some conclusions from the last class. So what are the conclusions from last class? Last class, I explained about MDA radar. Types of MDA radar and the function, different applications of an MDA radar. So here, coming to an MDA radar, where MDA radar is nothing but moving target indication radar, where the pulse waveform is used as an electromagnetic beam towards the moving target. Mainly MDA radars are two types, only the difference in transmitter section, power amplifier transmitter MDA radar and the power oscillator transmitter MDA radar, right? So while you compare this MDA radar with the continuous wave radar, where the continuous wave radar, both unmodulated continuous wave radar and frequency modulated continuous wave radar, both radars are used to detect the moving targets, right? And this MDA radar also used to detect the moving targets, right? So when you compare this MDA radar with the continuous wave radars, only the difference is noise influence is reduced in a MDA radar, right? So that means in mainly MDA radar eliminates the clutter echoes. We know that the clutter echoes. What are the clutter echoes? Clutter echoes are nothing but echoes from the stationary targets, right? MDA radar means to detect the moving targets, right? But the echo signal, from the MDA radar receiver is consisting of both the echoes from the stationary targets as well as the echoes from the moving targets, right? Now the MDA radar receiver should eliminate the echoes from the fixed targets, and it should process the echoes from the moving targets, right? So for that purpose, in order to eliminate the echoes from the stationary targets, which are called as clutter echoes, we are using delay line cancellers in the MDA radar receiver, right? These are the topics from the last class, I think. So see here, what is the last class? Whatever may be the power amplifier transmitter MDA radar or power oscillator transmitter MDA radar, whatever may be the blank, the output of phase detector, that is output of MDA radar receiver, is given to a delay line canceller, where delay line canceller is used to remove the clutter echoes, where clutter echoes are the echoes from the stationary or fixed targets, right? I think up to this concept you are clear, right? Now we'll see the new concept called butterfly effect in an MDA radar, right? So, in order to explain this butterfly effect in MDA radar, I considered these images. See, SEMA here. So, see these pictures, these waveforms. See here, these are the echo signal from the MDA radar receiver. This is the echo for first sweep, right? Antenna projecting a beam towards the moving target is called a sweep, right? At first sweep, this is an echo signal. And for the second sweep, this is the echo. And for the third sweep, this one. And fourth sweep, this one. And fifth sweep, this one, right? This is the integrated pulse, right? So see here. Actually, if you consider a single echo pulse from an MDA radar receiver, right? SEMA here, if you consider a single echo pulse from the MDA radar receiver, it is difficult to identify clutter echo and moving target echo, right? That means the echo from the noise components and echo from the actual target, right? So if you observe this one, there is no difference between the clutter echoes and the echo from the moving target, right? So in order to differentiate, observe the concept here, in order to differentiate echoes, clutter echoes and moving target echoes, you need to consider more than one echo pulse, right? Already we know that concept called integration of radar pulses, right? So you know the concept of integration of radar pulses. Why we are performing an integration of radar pulses? In order to improve the probability of detection and in order to decrease the probability of false alarm, right? So for an accurate detection, we are using the integration of radar pulses, right? I already explained that concept. What is an integration of radar pulses? We are considering more than one echo pulse. We are considering, that means we are considering the n number of echo pulses, and integrated output is considered to detect the target and to analyze the parameters of the target, right? So in a similar way, here also we considered more than one echo pulse, right? Now observe all the echo pulses for all the fields, right? When you observe here the echo A, B, C, D, E up to E, right? You are observing some echo with constant amplitude and some are with the varying amplitude, right? If you observe this one here, this is having a constant amplitude. Here it is having same amplitude. Here also it is having same amplitude, and here also it is having same amplitude. And here it is same, and here it is same. That means here this pulse is having constant amplitude in all the waves, right? In all the waves, right? So, and see here, this is having some amplitude here, and this is having some other amplitude, some other, and here this amplitude is changes, right? Or see, like this one, and this is, here also it is having, assume this one is one pulse, and see here this one, it is having high amplitude here. Amplitude decreases here when compared to here, right? And it is again decreased here when compared to previous pulse. Again, it decreases when compared to the previous wave. Here, it maintains a constant value, right? And see this pulse, right? Here, it is having some amplitude. Here, it is same as like the previous. Here, also same when compared with the previous. Here, also same when compared to the same. Previous one, right? So here what you need to identify the concept here, the echo pulse, the pulse which is having a constant amplitude in all the sweeps or nothing but the echoes from the stationary targets. Stationary target offers always an echo with a constant amplitude and constant frequency, okay? And the echoes from the moving targets or with the varying amplitudes and varying frequency, because the moving target is moving, right? The target is moving, right? So it is having a varying amplitude, right? So here, what is the concept now? Butterfly effect. So see here, what is the concept? Butterfly effect in empty air radar. So here only the simple concept is, when you integrate all the sweep pulses, the integrated pulse, when you integrated all these pulses, the integrated pulse is having constant amplitude as like in the previous sweep for the echo of the fixed target, that is clutter echo. But whereas the echoes from the moving targets having the varying amplitude is appears like this. That is, what is the shape of this one? This is the shape of butterfly, right? So, and here also, this is also a varying amplitude, where this is the constant amplitude appears same as like in the previous sweeps, right? But whereas coming to the varying amplitude sweeps integrated, then the shape becomes a butterfly shape, right? So this is the effect called butterfly effect in an MTA radar. This is the concept which gives you a butterfly effect in an MTA radar. So see now here, only the two lines of conclusion here, right? When you consider a single echo pulse from an MTA radar, it is difficult to differentiate echoes of stationary targets and echoes of the moving targets, right? So in order to differentiate echoes of the stationary targets, which are called as clutter echoes, from the echoes of the moving targets, you need to consider more than one echo pulse, right? So whenever you consider n number of echo pulses, the pulse having constant amplitude is the echo from the stationary target, right? And the pulse which is having varying amplitude is called the echo from the moving target, right? So when you integrate all these n number of echo pulses, the integrated output is having constant amplitude in case of a flutter echo, and in the shape of butterfly in case of the echoes of the moving target, right? That effect is called as here butterfly effect in an MTA header, right? So here, see these lines. Moving targets may be distinguished from the stationary targets by observing the video output on A-scope, where A-scope is nothing but our radar display mark, right? On that A-scope, the information is presented by considering amplitude versus range, right? A single sweep on A-scope might appear like this. The single sweep, right? So it is difficult to identify the echoes of stationary targets and echoes of the moving targets, right? What I already explained. So this sweep shows several fixed targets and two moving targets indicated by the two arrows on the basis of a single sweep, right? Moving targets cannot be distinguished from the fixed targets, right? So in order to distinguish and in order to differentiate both the echoes, we are considering n number of echoes. So here successive A-scope sweeps are shown in figure B to E. So we are considering from B to E, right? What I already explained. So echoes from fixed targets remain constant throughout, but echoes from the moving targets vary in amplitude from sweep to sweep at a rate corresponding to Doppler frequency, right? The superposition of the successive A-scope sweeps is shown in figure J, and the moving targets produce with the time a butterfly effect on the A-scope, right? So see here. So your next topic is delay line cancers, right? So I already told that Seema, here we are analyzing the concept what is going to happen in an MTA radar, right? We are not eliminating that one. That means if you consider this single echo pulse, it consists of an echo of the flutter, echo from the stationary targets and echo from the moving objects or moving targets, right? But the ultimate function of MTA radar is only the detection of moving targets, not the detection of flutter echoes. That is the echoes from the stationary targets, right? So in order to perform that task in an MTA radar, we are using delay line canceller, right? Where delay line canceller is a filter which is used to detect, which is used to eliminate the flutter echoes, right? So I think now you got the concept of delay line canceller, where we how it is related to MTA radar receiver. In an MTA radar receiver, after the phase detector, the Doppler information is given to a delay line. So I think now you can assume the concept here. What is the output to this one? Actually, this is the output to delay line canceller, where it consists of echoes of the fixed targets and as well as the echoes of the moving targets, right? So now the delay line canceller should eliminate the echoes of stationary targets, which is called as flutter echo, and it should allow the echoes of the moving targets, right? So for that purpose, we are using a delay line canceller. So see here. Delay line canceller is a filter which eliminates the DC components of echo signals and received from the stationary targets, right? And it allows the AC components of an echo signals received from the non-stationary targets, that is moving targets, right? Basically, I think now you got the concept why we are using delay line cancellers in an MTA radar, right? Now, coming to the types of delay line cancellers, basically the delay line cancellers are of two types: time domain filter delay line cancellers, and the second one is the frequency domain filter delay line cancellers. Okay.
in cancer. But what I have been told, ma, delay line cancer is due to eliminate the echoes of the stationary rockets, right? So those are nothing but the clutter echoes, right? Now I will explain how it eliminates the clutter echoes, right? So in order to explain that, consider a delay line cancer. Basically, the time domain delay line cancer or single delay line cancer, right? Actually, delay line cancer is nothing but the combination of delay line and the subtractor is called as the delay line cancer. So see here, this is the delay line and this is the subtractor. Both the combination of the delay line and the subtractor is called as the delay line cancer, right? It is used in a radar receiver after the output of a phase detector. Phase detector output is fed to the delay line cancer, where delay line cancer is a combination of delay line and the subtractor, and the output of delay line cancer is applied to a full power rectifier, right? So here, why we are using a full power rectifier means actually for what we are using this moving target indication radar, moving targets, right? In a real time, what are the moving targets? My aeroplanes, right? So for a plane position display. Plane position indicator. In order to display the plane position, we are using the display type called plane position indicator, right? So that plane position indicator or plane position display is only displays the unipolar signals, right? But the output of subtractor is a the output of a delay line cancer is a bipolar video, right? So in order to convert the unipolar signal into the bipolar signal, here the full power rectifier is used. Okay. So now see how this delay line cancer eliminates the clutter echoes, right? So see, ma, here what I already told that the clutter echoes are having the constant amplitude in all the sweeps, right? Constant amplitude means DC signal, right? So see here. So whenever you applied a constant amplitude to the subtractor, then what is the output of subtractor? It is zero, right? Because it is having a, for example, constant amplitude of 4 volts, right? 4 minus 4 minus 4, right? It is becomes zero, right? So see here, the MTA radar receiver output is given to delay line, where it provides some delay to the particular signal, right? The delayed version of received signal is given as one input to the subtractor, and another input is the original signal which is received by the MTA radar receiver, right? Now these two signals are given for the reference, right? So this input is for the reference, right? Now these inputs are given to a subtractor. Now the constant amplitudes are subtracted and the output of the subtractor is zero, and the output is here. So what are the input ma here with constant amplitude and varying amplitude, right? Varying amplitude, right? So when we subtract the varying amplitude, we have some reference values, reference voltage value, some voltage value at the output of a subtractor. So that means only the varying amplitudes are present at the output of subtractor, and constant amplitudes are eliminated. That means clutter echoes are eliminated, right? So in this manner, the delay line canceller, eliminates the echoes from the stationary target, which are called as the clutter echoes, right? After that, here now the signal is a bipolar signal. So as the plane position indicator, what is the final block in a radar system? Radar display is the final block, what I already shown that, right? So here, plane position indicator is a display used by the MTA radar, right? In order to locate the plane position, aeroplane position, right? So, okay, as it's compatible with only the unipolar video, you need to convert that into a unipolar, from bipolar to unipolar. So for that purpose, here full power rectifier is used. Okay. So from the output of full power rectifier is given to an indicator to display the plane position, right? So So actually, this is about a single delay line canceller where the combination of delay line and subtractor is used as a delay line canceller. Okay. So I think you got the concept. Okay. Now we'll see mathematically how the subtraction of signals is performed by using the single delay line canceller. Okay. So see here, actually if you assume this voltage is transmitted into the free space. Okay. Right. Theme here, that equation as V1 is equals to A sine 2 pi f dt minus phi naught, right? Where we know that A is the amplitude of video signal, FD is the Doppler information, right? Whenever the transmitting frequency hits the moving target, definitely there is a shift in frequency. The shift is called Doppler shift, and that is denoted with the letter FD, right? And that phenomena is called as the Doppler effect, right? Actually, that was the concept, right? Now, A is the amplitude of the video signal and FD is the Doppler frequency, and phi naught is the phase shift, and it is equal to 4 pi FD or naught by C. Now we will get the output of delay line canceller by replacing T by T minus TT, because where the T is the time required to reach the signal from radar system to target and from target to radar system. Actually, we know this T, right? Now, where this delay line, where we are using delay line, that provides some delay to that signal, right? How much of that delay, T minus TT amount of delay, is provided by using this delay line, right? That is indicated here. See, T minus, now this equation, now this equation is replaced with T minus TT. So V2 is equal to A sine 2 pi FD of T minus TT minus phi naught, where phi naught is the phase angle information, right? So this is the phase information. Okay. So see here, where TP is the pulse repetition time interval. TP, how much amount means TP is the pulse repetition time interval. Okay. So, and see the output here. Now, the input is given to a subtractor from the delay line. So, what is the output of the subtractor? V1 minus V2, where we know that V1 is nothing but with the T, and V2 is the delayed version of that signal, right? A sine of 2 pi FDT minus phi naught minus A sine of 2 pi FD of with the delayed version is T minus TP minus phi naught, right? Simple calculation, substitutions and simple calculations, right? So by substituting the formula, the final equation becomes V1 minus V2 is equal to 2A sine of pi FD TP cos 2 pi FD of T minus TP by 2 minus phi naught, right? So now the output of subtractor is applied as input to fullware expert, right? This is the output of the subtractor. So now this one is converted into a unipolar signal with the help of a fullware rectifier, right? So therefore the output of fullware rectifier is shown in this figure. See here. We all know that this is the output from the fullware rectifier, right? Where it opens for the both the half cycles, right? So see here. Actually, output of fullware rectifier means output indirectly, it is an observe the concept now here. This is actually the output of a MTA radar receiver. Am I right? Because delay line canceller is a sublock in MTA radar receiver. Am I right? This is the output of an MTA radar. Are you agree with this? Yes, this is the output of an MTA radar receiver, because delay line canceller is a one sublock of MTA radar, right? Actually, this is MTA radar where we are using delay line canceller here in order to delay, in order to eliminate an clutter echoes, right? So now the output of delay line canceller is nothing but the output of an MTA radar receiver, right? So see here, we have to give some conclusions from here. So if you observe and analyze this output response of an MTI radar receiver. If you observe and analyze the output response of an MTI radar receiver, the response becomes zero at some particular time interval, right? Are you agree with this? The response becomes zero at some particular time interval. So you here the response of an MTI radar becomes zero at some particular time interval. What is that particular time interval? 1/TP, where 1/TP is nothing but FP, where FP is nothing but pulse repetition frequency. So see here, you can define this concept like this. The MTI radar receiver response becomes zero at pulse repetition frequency, and the time intervals of the the integer multiples of the pulse repetition frequency. I agree with this. The MTI radar receiver, so MTI radar response or the relative velocity of the MTI radar becomes zero at pulse repetition frequency and the integer multiples of the pulse repetition frequency. That concept is called as flying speed, right? So this is the one time at this the response zero, and at this time it will be zero, and it becomes zero here, and it becomes zero here, right? So on whole, MTI radar relative velocity of the MTI radar response is zero at pulse repetition frequency and the integer multiples of the pulse repetition frequency, right? So on whole, here you need to catch two concepts. First one is, in order to eliminate clutter echoes, we are using delay line cancellers in an MTI radar, right? So with the delay line canceller, clutter echoes are eliminated up to the maximum extent, not 100%, up to the maximum extent the clutter echoes are eliminated. But by using the delay line cancellers, right? But by using the delay line cancellers and Fulvia Rectifier is a sub-block of delay line canceller, right? By using the delay line cancellers, the MTI radar response becomes zero at some particular frequencies. So the relative velocity at which the MTI radar response is zero is called the blind speed. Here I am introducing another new concept that is called blind speed, where blind speed is nothing but the relative velocity at which the MTI radar response becomes zero. That is called as blind speed, right? So on whole, the main conclusion is in an MTI radar receiver, in order to eliminate clutter echoes, we are using delay line cancellers, right? But at the same time, by using the delay line cancellers, blind speeds are introduced in an MTI radar receiver response, right? I think you got the concept, right? With this, I'll end today's class. We'll continue in the next class. If you have any doubts, please ask.